بالحيوانات. لقد صار معنا أي حل بيننا، وصار فينا متحدا بالإنسان المؤمن، وصار لنا نعمة التبني، فنكون أبناء أحباء وندعوه أبانا في كل حين. ثالثا، العمق الجديد، المحبة. الله محبة، وبمحبته أخرج الأرض من العدم إلى الوجود، ووهب الإنسان صورته ومثاله. ولكن الإنسان اختار الضعف وأوجد نفسه خارج الفردوس طريدا بلا خلاص. ولكن الله لم يخلق ليدين ويهدم، بل ليخلص ويخلد. فكانت البداية هي تجسده، لأنه هكذا أحب الله العالم حتى بذل ابنه الوحيد لكي لا يهلك كل من يؤمن به، بل تكون له حياة أبدية. الله عندما خلقنا عرفنا أنه يحبنا، ولكن عندما تجسد عرفنا أنه يحبنا جدا، محبة لا تحد ولا توصف، بل تتحدى أفهامنا وأدراكنا ومعارفنا. فالميلاد أعطانا بعدا روحيا أو وصفا روحيا فائق العمق لم يختبره الإنسان من قبل. لقد نلنا نعمة التبني وصرنا بالحقيقة أبناء الله. وأما كل الذين قبلوه فأعطاهم سلطانا أن يصيروا أبناء الله، أي المؤمنون باسمه. فقد حل الإبن الكلمة في وسطنا وصار بكرا بين إخوة كثيرين. وهذا العمق الجديد نراه واضحا في كل الذين اجتمعوا حول المزود. فمثلا في يوسف النجار الشيخ الوقور، حامل استقامة العهد القديم وحارس سر التجسد. كذلك مريم العذراء المختارة دائمة البتولية، حاملة صورة العهد الجديد وخادمة سر التجسد. وكذلك نراه في إصرار المجوس الغرباء الباحثين على الحقيقة، والذين قدموا أتعابهم واجتهاداتهم وأوقاتهم قبل أن يقدموا هداياهم الثمينة من الذهب والمر واللبان. حتى الملائكة في تسبيحها تعطي المجد لله في الأعالي لأنه تجسد، وتعلن السلام على الأرض لأنه صلب، ثم تعلن الفرح على كل الناس لأنه قام. حتى الملائكة في تسبيحها تعطي السلام المجد في الأعالي لأنه تجسد، وتعلن السلام على الأرض لأنه صلب، ثم تفرح كل الناس لأنه قام. هذا العمق الجديد بالميلاد هو بدء أفراح موكب الخلاص وانتهاء الخصومة بين الله والبشر. هكذا صارت المصالحة. المسيح إلهنا يبارك هذا العام ويعطيه السلام الحقيقي مع خالص محبتي لجميعكم، وكل عام وأنتم بخير. البابا تودروس الثاني. يعني سيدنا حب يوضح لنا ثلاث معاني جديدة أو ثلاث عناصر جديدة خدناها بسر التجسد النهاردة. اسم جديد عمانوئيل الله معنا، وعدنا أن هو يكون معانا من الآن وإلى آخر ليه؟ الظهور. وده طبعا سر إيه؟ فرحنا. ثاني حاجة، كيانه الجديد، أن الله تجسد، الله ظهر في الجسد وصار واحدا منا، فبقى قريب مننا. معلمنا يوحنا يقول الذي لمسناه، الذي رأيناه، من جهة كلمة الحياة نكلمكم به. ربنا بقى قريب قوي، بقى معانا ومعانا بالجسد، يعني محسوس، يعني ملموس، يعني ممكن ناكله ونشربه ونتحد بيه ويتحد بينا. عشان كده كان عمق مشيئة الله مش بس ان يكون معانا، ان احنا كمان نكون ايه؟ معانا. يلا فرصة بقى نسأل نفسنا، ربنا معانا دي ما فيهاش يعني نو داوت اباوت، فيهاش شك في الموضوع ده. طب يا ترى احنا معايا ولا لا؟ فرصة نسأل نفسنا. العمق الجديد عمق المحبة. الله لما خلق الإنسان، وده اختلاف المسيحية عن أي ديانة أخرى أو أي اعتقاد آخر، المعتقدات الأخرى ترى الله في جبروته، ولكننا نرى الله في محبته. المحبة طبعا لا تلغي الجبروت، ولكن عايز أقول الله أحبنا مش بس لأنه خلقنا، لا، لما خلقنا وسقطنا عمل إيه؟ تجسد لكي ما يخلصنا، لأنه ليس حب أعظم من هذا أن يضع أحد نفسه لأجل أحبائه. وهكذا أحب الله العالم حتى بذل ابنه الوحيد لكي لا يهلك كل من يؤمن به بل تكون له حياة أبدية. اسم جديد، كيان جديد، وعمق جديد. ربنا يدينا نحن نعيش في المعاني الحلوة علشان نعيش وإحنا واثقين أن الله معنا ومعانا بحضور حقيقي ظاهر ملموس ولن يفارقنا، وجوده معانا يكون لنا سبب فرح وسبب سلام ويكون لنا هو عمق المحبة. The Feaster Letter for the Glorious Feast of the Nativity for our beloved Father, His Grace Bishop Serapion. My beloved, the blessed children of the Holy Church, it is my pleasure to wish you a blessed feast of Nativity, in which we celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, who was incarnate for our salvation. The birth of Christ is a new beginning for all mankind. Through his birth, our Lord Jesus Christ has shined on humanity, similar to when light dawns and shines in the pitch darkness. Saint John said, "And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it." That was the true light, which gives light to every man coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, and the world did not know him. Also, St. Matthew mentioned Isaiah's prophecy, which said, "The people who sat in darkness have seen a great light, and upon those who sat in the region and the shadow of death, light has dawned." My beloved, the birth of Christ hold a new, joyful, and bright relationship between God and man, and man and God, as well as man and his fellow man. The birth of Christ holds a new, joyful, and bright relationship between God and man, man and God, as well as man and his fellow man. God is in his great love created man in his image and likeness. However, man did not abide in God's love and sinned, thus coming under the condemnation of death. Yet God's love for man did not change. Man changed and could no longer feel God's love and walk away from God in the darkness of evil. Though our Lord Jesus Christ incarnation, he shined on us by the light of God's love. As Saint John wrote, "In this the love of God was manifested towards us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might live through him. In this love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sin." The birth of Christ is a new beginning in the relationship of God to man. It is a new covenant, the covenant of salvation. It is a new covenant, the covenant of salvation. Therefore, we find the hymn of the Nativity sing the praises of the work of salvation. The Holy Virgin praised God, saying, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit has rejoiced in God my Savior." She added, "He has shown strength with his arm, and has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has put down the mighty from their thrones and exalted the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham and his seed forever. Also Zacharias, the priest, praised God saying, Blessed is the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited and redeemed his people, and has raised up a horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David. As for Simon the elder, when he took up in his arm the baby Jesus, he blessed God and said, Lord, now you are letting your servant depart in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, a light to bring revelation to the Gentile and glory of your people Israel. It is the good news of salvation for everyone, both for Israel and for the Gentile. Without distinction, since Christ came to save all of mankind. The birth of Christ is the reconciliation for all humanity. As St. Paul said, all things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Now all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ, and has given us the ministry of reconciliation, that is, God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself, not imputing their trespasses to them, and has committed to us the word of reconciliation. The birth of Christ is the message of reconciliation. For us, as St. Paul said, now then we are ambassadors for Christ. And through God, we're pleading through us, we implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. One more time. Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ. And through God, we're pleading through us, we implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. This is the message which you have delivered to everyone. The call for reconciliation is an invitation for a new relationship with God, a relation based on love. We love Him because He first loved us. Love means abiding in God, because God is love, and he who abides in love abides in God and God in him. However, abiding in God is based on having the correct faith. For whoever confesses that Jesus is the Son of God, God abides in him and he in God. It is through the holy sacraments that the Holy Spirit gives us the new nature and the continual repentance, so that we can continue to abide in Christ. For by this we know that we abide in him and he in us, because he has given us of his Spirit. Our continuous abidance in God is nourished by our partaking of his holy body and precious blood. For he who eats my flesh and drinks my body, drinks my blood, abides in me and I in him. The birth of Christ gives us a new beginning in our relationship with one another. For the person who abides in love of God opened his heart with love towards our people. And this commandment we have from him, that he who loves God must love his brother also. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. Let us rejoice in our Lord, who loved us and came to our world to save us. to make us abide in him and to make us abide in love for one another. Let us pray for the peace of the Holy Church and for our beloved Father, His Holiness Pope Tawadros II. Let us pray for our beloved countries, America and Egypt, and the peace may prevail in the whole world. Wishing you many happy returns, His Grace Bishop Serapion. So to summarize His Grace message, it's about reconciliation between us and God through mutual love. Mutual love. And we have to love God, or at least ask Him to help us love Him as He loves us. And we ought to love one another as He loved us so much. So let us be rejoiced today for the incarnation of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us remind ourselves that His name is Emmanuel. The Lord is with us, and He will be with us forever. And we have this privilege to abide in Him and He in us through partaking of His holy body and His precious blood. Just we have to be prepared and prepare ourselves and offer repentance and ask God to purify our heart, our mind, our senses, our souls, our intention, and make us worthy to partake of Him, that He may abide in us, and we in Him, now, forever, and until the age of all ages. Amen. And glory be to God forever.